Like you, they don't mind firing their missiles right next to schools, knowing those skilled children would die when the missile comes back. They're just like your mentality.
Okay,
you,
okay.
You care about
you
the
just said, you just said, hold on, you keep your own people in hold on,
you keep your own people in Iran.
Okay, hold on,
same mentality,
hold on,
God in Palestine.
Hold on. You just said Hamas is like me. Yes?
Same mentality.
Okay, hold on, hold on. Hold on.
Do you agree with that?
Hold on. Can I speak?
You could have said you
can I speak?
You
just said, thank you. You just said that I am like Hamas. Now, hold on. Same mentality? Okay, I am British. Is Hamas British?
No.
Then how can you say we are same?
Is it illegal?
I'll tell you. Same mentality that all the suicide bombers in Britain, in the London Underground, on buses, in pop concerts in Manchester, driving cars into civilians on London Bridge twice, all those stabbings done by Muslims in Britain, but with the same mentality that they got in Yemen, Palestine, Lebanon, Syria, Iraq. Same mentality.
Okay.
But I asked him several times,
hold on.
Do you agree with five missiles next to school?
He's good. Okay. What about Al Jazeera building?
I answered.
Okay, hold on.
She wants him to ask a question. She doesn't like me answering.
You're not answering. He's running away.
She doesn't like me answering.
No, you're not answering.
Okay,
excuse me. Why do you have to insult ladies? Is that what you Jews do?
Because she deserves it.
No. Why? Are you
in speaker's corner?
Yeah.
If you act stupidly, it gets pointed out.
Yeah. No, you don't need to tell me. I'm acting like a speaker, but you're acting stupid because you are insulting a woman.
She deserves it.
What, to be insulted?
She's being stupid.
Okay.
If she was a child, I wouldn't.
Can I ask you?
So I point out the stupidity of her. She, unless you ask a question, she doesn't let me answer your question.
Okay,
she
can I ask you?
Shut up and let you speak.
Can I ask you another one? Can I ask you another one? I have seen Palestinian demonstrations in this country, even in London. Why are you pushing the woman, man?
She's got this poking my
Hold on. You almost assaulted her. You're assaulting her.
She almost assaulted me.
Okay. But you're the one pushing. You're the one pushing.
Free Palestine. Fuck Israel.
Okay, hold on. No swearing. Okay, hold on. Okay, I am, before he makes an excuse, now, let me ask you, I have seen demonstrations in this country, even in London, where different Muslims, Arabs, non-Arabs, Palestinians, non-Palestinians, British, you know, European people, people from different religions, demonstrating for the Palestinians, and I have seen Jewish people with long hair, religious Jews. Okay, hold on, listen to me. And I have seen Jewish people, religious, long hair, also in those demonstrations supporting on behalf of the Palestinians. Are those real Jews, or are you the real Jews?
We're all Jews.
They are all Jews. Okay. Right. So those
okay,
Jews.
Are you going to answer your question? You went on.
Yeah.
Are you going to answer?
Why are you fed up?
I personally have been on Free Palestine demonstrations.
So oh, have you?
Hold on.
Did you say you have been on demonstrations of Free Palestine? Have you been there?
Yes, I have.
So do you support the freedom for Palestine?
I've told you several times. I've got a badge here for the stupid.
Yeah.
There's a Palestinian flag.
Okay.
And there's an Israeli flag.
Okay.
And I said several times in your earshot, I believe in two states, a Palestine and Israel.
Okay.
And as soon as Palestinians make peace with Israel, then there'll be two states.
Okay.
Did you get it that time?
Okay. Hold on.
Did you get it, yes or no?
During the bombings, You talk about Hamas?
Yeah.
During bombings?
No, you're not allowed. Please,
some officers.
No.
Of
Hold on.
Okay. You know, in those bombings,
we don't want to lose you.
I have seen offices of Al Jazeera building blown away.
Yeah.
Was Al Jazeera part of Hamas? Yeah, why?
They're supporting Hamas. They're using that to try and jam that building. To jam the Iron Dome system.
Who was doing? Who was trying to jam?
He's been shouting.
Okay, hold on.
Why is it the
way
you go? Okay. Shout each other down.
Okay, no. We're not shouting each other. Okay.
Why you want to come here to London?
Okay.
Government,
you're
government.
Sick. Okay, excuse me. Were the Palestinians there in Palestine before most of the Jews who are there now?
There's always been Jews over there.
Do you need a hand?
But mostly it was Palestinians.
In the Quran, says the children of Israel will return.
Who are the children of Israel?
Are you stupid? Hey,
no, you're being stupid. Don't insult, you're stupid.
I can see why the Palestinians...
Don't call us British stupid because you're stupid.
Because they're not very well-educated.
Who is not well-educated?
In the Quran it says, all blessings and good things come from Allah.
Yeah.
I ask you, why is the Muslim world a complete mess, the worst place to live in the world? Why is that? You never answered.
What's
you
right? Never answered. Okay, hold on.
United Arab Emirates. They have fired a rocket to Mars. Hamas fires rockets at civilians in Israel. Big difference. Allah is blessing United Arab Emirates.
Why are you spitting on her?
That's my throat sweet. I'm having difficulty trying to avoid this lady.
No, why don't you let her speak, man? Why don't you let her speak?
No, he won't answer your question.
She doesn't. She's like you. She just said, "Stay."
What do you mean she's like me? She's like me.
So
you're being devilish.
Blesses everyone who deserves it. So yes, United Arab Emirates deserves it. It's doing very well. I love United Arab Emirates.
Okay, how?
But most Muslim countries are actual basket cases.
You guys cannot be
Okay. He's not answering your question.
Any day they want, the Palestinians can go again and negotiate with Israel.
Excuse me.
There's nothing to stop them.
Okay.
They could go again. If they want peace, go again.
What do you think?
And they walked away. The Palestinians 8 years ago walked away from the negotiating table.
Okay.
Even Barack Obama said, "I'm not going to help you to Mohammed Abbas because you are negotiating with Israel." No, I took it out between the Israelis and the Palestinians. Nothing could stop the negotiating. Israel wants to, and the Palestinians won't.
How do you know that?
They're useless, absolutely.
No. You're just blaming one side and you're saying the other side is completely right.
No, I never said they're completely
right. How long can you fight?
I never once said they're completely right.
Yeah.
I condemn Israel building settlements on Palestinian land.
Can they do that?
They can, but they shouldn't.
Oh, right, okay. I agree with you there. Okay, why shouldn't they? I agree with you there. Why shouldn't the Israelis build the settlements? Why?
Yes.
Because they should obey international law.
All right, okay.
But it's a grey area.
That's good.
In the Geneva Convention of War, it says the occupying power shall not transfer its population to the territory occupied.
Okay.
The problem is that only exists between two countries who both signed the Geneva Convention.
Yeah.
And the Palestinians didn't sign them until 2014, only 5-6 years ago.
Yeah.
So any before that, they weren't against the law.
Which Palestinians would you think you are able to negotiate with?
Not Hamas, not Islamic Jihad. Fatah maybe if they really push to it. But they've got all their friends in Europe, around the world, telling them don't go negotiate. Keep making Israel look bad. So they won't go negotiate.
You're trying to blame everybody else, Yusuf. People are fed up with that war. They want negotiations.
The right. Palestinians have been told by time again, go and negotiate with Israel. But they won't.
Who? Which
in
one?
The past, do it now. Just because you did it in the past, I mean, you're going to do it ever again. The occupation will continue until the peace deal. So the longer the people they delay negotiations, the longer the occupation goes on.
Do you want that?
Okay. Do you want it to go on?
Okay, can I ask one other question?
I want to negotiate as soon as possible.
Did you say?
And get independence as soon as possible.
Okay, did you say the occupation will last long and long and long? Did you say that?
Only if the Palestinians don't negotiate.
Okay, right. Can I say to you, in history, there have been many empires. In history, there have been many powerful countries. But now they are no more. Are you telling us that in Palestine, the Israelites in Palestine, they are going to be there forever?
According to God, yes.
Where is it written?
In the Jewish Torah, yeah, and the Christian Gospels and the Muslim Quran.
But you're not a Christian, are you? Okay, you're Jewish. Okay.
I didn't write any of those books.
Okay. Do you?
You can either accept what those books say or find excuses not to.
Do you agree with the Christians?
On some things. I agree with them. What Jesus said about the Jews returning. Yeah, I agree with that.
So, but you don't believe in Jesus?
It doesn't matter. But it's all about me.
Yeah.
I'm saying the reason why Palestine is still occupied is because they won't go negotiate. In 1967, the Palestinians and five Arab armies attacked Israel.
Okay,
Hang on. Israel took the land from all of them and said, if you make peace with us, you'll get your land back. Eventually, Egypt made peace and they got their land back. Then Jordan made peace and they got their land back.
Okay.
The Palestinians told them, when you make peace, you get your land back.
Okay.
Can I ask you?
Go on. You know the Crusaders? The Crusaders took over Jerusalem for less than 100 years.
And about 200,
not 200 years. Okay. Less than 100 years. Okay. And then eventually, the Sultan Salahuddin, the Muslim, they retook Jerusalem back.
Right.
Why? Because that area all around, it's Muslim countries, it's Muslims area, it's Muslim majority.
There are Christians out there as well. You treat them like they don't exist,
yeah,
but there are millions of Christians in the Middle East. Most
minority.
Of them now, because of people like you, are trying to get out of Iraq. One third of Christians have
I'm
left
not
Iraq
from Iraq. Excuse
Christians
me.
Christians are getting out of Syria. Christians getting out of Gaza.
Okay.
They're even getting out of Egypt because they've had so many of their churches attacked.
Whose Christian churches attacked?
Carry on.
What about the Muslim places of worship? What about the Muslim places of worship?
Do you know, in Israel, there's 450 mosques in Israel. Most of them have been built since the creation of Israel. But how many churches in the Muslim world? Almost none.
Yeah, but okay, let me tell you what reason.
Lots of new mosques, lots of new Christian churches. That's one of the reasons why Allah is blessing Israel.
Excuse me, let me tell you why. The number of Christian churches going down is because the number of Christians is decreasing or declining.
Because of persecution.
Persecution.
The Yazidis would like to get out as well.
Okay.
Especially the women.
Okay, right. But you talk about women. What about the Palestinian women? Aren't they women?
Yes, and they get much better life. The Arabs who live in Israel have a much better life than those of the Palestinian Arab
Do you agree? Do you agree that even in Western Europe, North America, in these different countries which are majority Christian, do you agree with me that the number of Christians is decreasing all the time?
No, it's not.
You don't? They are?
No. What's happening is, people are leaving the large established churches and setting up smaller independent ones.
So
the number of Christians is pretty similar, but the Catholic Church is losing lots and lots of people.
Okay, can I tell you, from the year 2000, from the year 2000 to around 2018, just in London, around 500 Christian churches have closed down.
Yes, Catholic Church of England Methodist ones like
you know why?
Yes, because they're moving away from established corrupt churches.
You know why?
I'm answering you.
Yeah.
If you're listening here.
Yeah.
They're moving away from the corrupt established churches and so they have small independent ones. There are lots of new churches in
London. So why? So
new churches in London.
No, that's new church. No, listen. New churches, maybe a few. But
a lot.
Listen, I have prayed in a Muslim place of worship in a masjid. I have prayed in about maybe three or four of them. There used to be churches before, but now they are Muslim places of worship. Why? Because Christians
Why?
Are becoming less,
because
Muslims
so many,
are growing more.
Because so many Muslims want to get out of the Muslim world
yeah.
to come live in the West.
Yeah.
That's why, because it's absolute crap living under Muslim rule in Pakistan, Bangladesh, Egypt, Tunisia, and they're crossing the, some are crossing the Mediterranean
okay.
Sea to get life. Some are flying
okay.
here, overstaying their visas. Some are coming here illegally because they get a much better life under rule of Western democracy,
okay.
which evolved out of Christianity.
Okay.
A much better life than they do in the Muslim world.
Okay, did you
and
say?
And I've been all around the Muslim world, and I can see why you don't want to live there.
Did you?
I can see why you don't want to live there. Yes.
Did you say that Muslims are leaving the Muslim world? They are coming to these countries.
Okay, let me. To the West.
Okay,
to the West. In their tens of millions,
okay.
they go to America, Australia, Canada, New Zealand, Germany, Sweden. They don't go to Somalia or Afghanistan or Libya or Syria or Iraq or Iran. They're getting out of those countries
okay.
to live in the West.
Okay, do
and
you?
No one is getting on a small boat
excuse
from
me.
Europe trying to get into
excuse
the
me.
Western world.
Excuse
doesn't
me.
Happen.
Excuse me. You're a Jewish guy. You seem to have a problem with the Muslims settling in these countries.
No.
But did you know?
He put words
can
in my
I finish?
Mouth. I was explaining why they came here.
Yeah.
I didn't say it's a problem.
Can I?
But he's pretending that
can I tell
a
you?
I was just explaining why you don't want to live under Muslim rule. You do much better in the West.
Excuse me.
And I don't blame you.
Excuse
I
me.
I don't blame you.
Can I tell you?
And you want to get your cousins and your uncles
excuse
and your
me.
Aunt over here as
excuse
well.
Excuse me. We are here because the governments in these countries, they needed us. They needed the workforce. They needed the doctors.
No.
They needed the scientists.
No.
They needed the university professors.
No.
They needed.
Very, very
that's
few.
Why we are here.
Very, very few.
Okay.
Most Muslims in this country are in the lowest paid jobs.
Okay.
A small percentage of scientists, but most of them in low paid jobs. And so they come over here.
Okay.
And because we're in the British Commonwealth, God bless the British Commonwealth, we've been allowing lots of you in. That's
okay.
nice of us, isn't it?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Well done.
You know why that's nice of you? Because during the First World War, more than 1 million Indian soldiers, they came to Europe to fight for these
yeah.
people.
Yeah.
Yes, they came
mostly
to
Hindus.
Fight for these people.
Mostly Hindus, but yes. Yeah.
What do you mean mostly Hindus?
Most Indians are Hindus.
But there were hundreds of thousands of Muslim soldiers as well.
What's your point? What's
okay.
your point?
My point is this. We are here because we
Because
did not
you don't live in your own miserable little countries.
What do you mean my miserable? I'm British. Is this miserable?
Your descendants,
how dare you?
The people who are coming here, the people who are coming here come from backward third world countries.
Okay, are you
of
British?
Of course they want to get out.
Are you British?
You know, Pakistan is a backward third world country. Their doctors come here. There's no national health service in Pakistan.
Excuse me, stop lying, mister. You're lying at the moment.
In England.
Excuse me.
Because
excuse
they don't care about your
are you,
country.
Are you?
They'd rather get out of the middle
are
of
you,
third world countries
are you,
and come live in the
is
West.
Is Islamophobic? Are you?
No, I'm not.
Are you British?
No, I'm not Islamophobic.
Are you British?
Yes.
You're so am I British.
Yeah.
So why you got a problem with us Muslims here?
Did I say I got a problem? You started
you have,
talking about it.
Yeah.
About the number of Muslims going up and Christians going down.
Yeah, and
that's
you're jealous.
That's why I said that. That's why I said that.
Yeah.
You've taken me off my subject of Israel Palestine.
Yeah.
And I'm asking your questions.
Yeah.
Very nicely and honestly of me.
Okay, yes. okay. You have to answer the questions, isn't it?
And you never answered mine. I asked you, do you think it's good for Hamas to fire missiles from right next to schools?
Okay, you won't okay. Answer. No. You never asked me that question. You never let me answer you. Let me answer you.
Okay, good.
Let me answer you.
Good.
I am not a member of Hamas. All right?
Ask if you were.
I have studied politics, but in Speaker's Corner, I never speak about politics. I am.
Hold on.
I can talk about politics. I've seen you here many years. I'm a speaker myself, you know it. Now, listen. Count the number of casualties from.
I said you wouldn't answer it.
Hold on, I'm answering.
Answer it.
I'm answering. He doesn't want to listen. I'm answering. He doesn't want to listen. I'm answering. No, you're being stupid. You're being stupid. Hey, excuse me. When a Muslim wants to answer, he doesn't want to listen. Why? He's got his own propaganda. Okay, you talk about those. Okay. Okay, let me answer. No problem. You talk about Hamas missiles. Now tell me.
No, you answer my question, not
can
me
I,
tell you.
Can I speak?
You just said tell me.
Allah, what that? Can I speak?
Every one of your questions.
Can I speak?
As soon as you answer.
Can I speak?
You won't answer my question.
I will. Can I speak?
Yes or no?
Okay,
do you agree with Hamas firing missiles right next to schools?
Okay, hold on. Hold on.
Yes or no?
Hold on. Any missiles, according to Islamic teachings, it tells us that Muslims, when they are fighting wars, we cannot kill women, we cannot kill children,
right.
We cannot hold on.
It's simple yes or no.
Will be yes or no, go home.
He's evading it.
Allahu Akbar, I'm not. You're scared, okay? First
yes
time.
Or no. Just answer yes or
okay.
No.
Will be yes or no, go home. I got plenty to talk about.
This man,
all right.
Does he
okay.
agree
hold
with
on.
Hamas firing missiles right next to schools? In one
can
second,
I speak?
I can say yes.
Can I speak?
Those people can answer.
He's scared of a Muslim to speak.
But he's avoiding
why
answering.
Why are you scared?
He's avoiding answering.
No, I'm not.
You're
shouting your head off above me. Listen.
Fire.
I will. Quiet. Okay. Okay. Don't shout at us, British. Okay. Now listen. According to Islamic teachings, no missile should be fired at any hospital, at any school, at any civilians. Now, you answer me. In the
now,
total casualties. Now, look, he's running away. He's running away. I answered you.
Is he answering no?
I've answered you. I've answered you. Now you're scared.
It's full of people like him.
Allahu Akbar. Now you're scared.
They don't answer each
other. Okay, hold on.
Twist.
I'm not twisting.
That's why
hold on.
The Muslim world is the most backward, God-forsaken place.